Hi and welcome, I am Helle, and lately I've been playing a lot of Blood on the Clocktower with different scripts. And I really also want to play the game in real life. Soon it will be possible for me, and therefore I have made my own print version of the game, because you can first get the game at the end of the year, or perhaps even first next year. So I can't wait that long, so I've made my own version. I'm going to show you in this video the version that I have made. And I've made it with this big box, and it's a pine tree box. It doesn't weigh that much because it's pine tree, and it's about 30 to 40 centimeters, and then you have the lid up here and you have the side. But let's take a look at what I have made. So here we have the box, and inside the box I have this filth, and I have put the same filth in the lid and in the bottom here. And this is some filth I have bought in at some places where you have fabrics, and it was kind of like this size, and I just cut it over, and I did the same with the bottom. And this is about 3 millimeters thick, so this is quite thick, this filth. And I have just glued the filth to the lid and to the bottom. And you need to have a bag where you can have the tokens in, and I just had a bag that I could use. So you need some kind of bag for your tokens when people they have to choose their token. And then I have printed out some where you can see the different roles you need for the number of players, and you can play this game for with 5 and up to 20 players. So this is the order where you can see how many townsfolks, outsiders, minions and demons you need. And I have printed it and laminated it. And this one is the town square, where you will have all a token for each player, where you can see if they are dead or alive, or if they have used their dead vote. And I will show this to you later on again. But this one I have printed, and I have also just laminated it. And then I have printed this one, also printed it, and I have laminated it. And here we have the first night, and then we have for every other night. So I will use this one and put up in the lid so I can see the night order where I have to wake up people. And then we have 20 of these. We have the roles, the script, the roles for each of the characters, and each player will get one of these. And this is also one I've printed and laminated. And then we have all the tokens, and we have used my husband's 3D printer to print these boxes, and I have tokens inside. And let's look at the tokens. And the first box that my husband has designed for me is for Trouble Brewing. We can put a little TB up here, so that's the tokens for the Trouble Brewing. And inside the box I have all the tokens for the characters for Trouble Brewing. And we have 3D printed these discs. And then I have printed these on some sticking paper, where I have printed all of these tokens, and I have cut them out and glued them and put them on here. That is stickers, some sticker paper. And on the other side I have filled, and I have made two versions of these. First I made a version like this, where I didn't have the text on it. That was before I found the files for this one. I will add a link for the files where you can print these tokens. And with the first one I used what you use for protecting your chairs, put underneath a chair or a table, and then I glued them on. But they are a lot thicker. Until I was in IKEA and I found this filth. I found this filth in IKEA, which is you will put underneath your blankets, carpet, so it won't slit. That is what you're going to use this for. But this was perfect for using for these tokens, and it cost nearly like nothing, only about I would say $3 or something for a lot of meters, square meters. This is there's more layers to this one, so it's really, really thin. And I have just glued these tokens on, and then I have cut them out. So there's a lot of work in doing so, especially with all the small tokens also. So this fabric here works really well to use underneath, and there it's really thin, so it's good to use underneath the tokens. So a little trip to IKEA and you can find to IKEA and you can find this. So all these little tokens are made in the same way, where we have printed some little discs, and I did buy these ones to put underneath, and then my husband, he designed these boxed for me, and if I used the old ones that I made first, then they would fill up all these free spaces. But now I have lots of empty space because these do not take up as much space with this filled on it. So this is pretty awesome. And then I have my little lid we can put on. And then we have some tokens. And in this one, we have the death tokens. And here we have designed these that would look a bit like the ones you have in the original game. And then I have put some of these filled stickers on. I have used some of these, and then I have cut them out to fit. So when a player die in the game, I can put this death token on them. And you can see it will stick out a bit here. So it will stick to the filled underneath, so it won't go off. We have these, a lot of these tokens, where you have two sides to them, a green side and a red side. And this is for each player to indicate if they are alive or if they have been killed in the game. And then I have these tokens, and this I will use on here for when to indicate the player they have still a vote when they have died. And when they have used their dead vote, I will remove it. So these I have used for two things, for the dead vote marker and as the token that we print these on. And then we have some more tokens. And this is just some helper tokens. I haven't finished them yet. I want to put glue. I want to put some stickers on here. I want to put stickers for numbers or a sticker to indicate that you have nominated. We need to keep track of who has nominated and how many votes each player they will receive. So I want to make some of these with numbers on, and also with other things that I might think could help me in the game to indicate stuff. So these I'm going to put stickers on too, and a lot of them will have numbers on them. And then we have these helpers that we are going to use to show to players during the game, because we can't talk to them. And this is again, these ones are 1.5 centimeters, and then I have put the filled on them, I have glued them, and then cut them out, all of these. There's a lot of work in making this one. So I would definitely prefer to, I just could have bought the game, but yeah, I couldn't, not at the moment. These ones are some ones we have 3D printed too, and then I have printed these stickers and put them on, and then we have glued the filled on and cut them out, like we have done with the other tokens. So these are ones, yeah. So that was all the normal tokens you need. But I have also made some tokens for sects and violets and for the travelers. I have made these, where you have, these are for sects and violets, all the characters for them. And we have used all of the little filled, and yeah, in the same way that I've made the others. And this is the travelers. So different travelers you have in the game. There are 15 of those, I think there were about 15. And then all the helper tokens for sex and violence. And I think there were 79 of these little ones. And them I have made with the IKEA filled, not like the ones I made first, where they have the big filled, but I've made it with this one. So they are a lot thinner, and I can have stack a lot of more of them. But still, it's a lot of work to make all of these. And then I've made these little ones for the travelers. You need to know if a traveler is good or evil. So I have made these. I think they're pretty, came out pretty well. They are also 1.5 centimeters. So if you're evil or good, and for the travelers here, you need to know if a traveler is evil or good. So you can use these tokens to mark that. And I also really like the inserts that we have made for these. And that's my husband that had designed them for me. And they fit perfect for all of these different tokens I have. And we have with this. And with these little small ones too, they also have their own little space. So pretty cool, I think. And here we have the town square set up with a game with 10 players. And here three players, they have died and they haven't used their dead vote. If one more player dies, you will turn over their token and they will get a death vote. And when they use their death vote, you will just remove it. And you can see that this player cannot vote anymore. And here I have set up the game, the Grimmore. And doesn't it look awesome? Up here, I want to lift this up a bit. We put something in here so it can be held here. And here I can have the rules, the night order. So for the first night, I would have it on this page. And then afterwards, I will turn it to the other page and follow the night order. And then I have the helper tokens for when I have to communicate with the players at the night. And then I have the Grimmore in here. And let me turn it around. And when I have to play the game, I will put it up like this. And I might have to turn it like this at some point. But all the things, they are steady. The filth works really great. And let's take a closer look inside the Grimmore here. And inside the Grimmore, I have set up the players over here. And this is the bluff rolls for the imp. And then I have some tokens that I'm going to use and some small helper tokens. I still need to put numbers on these and maybe put some other things that I think I'm going to use. So if a player nominates, if the imp nominated, for example, the virgin, then I could put these reminder tokens for that they have been nominated and they have nominated. And I would like to have numbers here. So if there was 3 votes on this one, I would put a token with a number 3. And then another player could nominate and another player would be nominated. And in that way, you can use these helper tokens during the game. Especially if you have a lot of players, you might really need to have help of these small helper tokens. Just need to put stickers on them. And some of these tokens you're not using in the game. You don't have to put them in the Grimmore. You can leave them out in a space where, of course, people can't see that they are not with in the game. That was a look at how I have made my print and play version of the game. And I will make sure that this one will get up to be about this way when I will walk around with it, so it's easier for me to see. And we just have to make sure that people can't look inside the Grimmore and see how you have set up the game. But what I have up here, it doesn't matter. They can see this one. So I'm really happy with how this turned out. And yeah, that is the way I made my own print and play version of Blood on the Clock Tower. And of course, I want to have the real version too when it comes out at some point. I would hope that I could grab it at Essen this year, but we'll see if they will be ready with the game at that time. Perhaps it will first be in the new year that I would be able to get the real game. But until then I can use my print and play version and play with my friends. And I will say thank you for watching. Bye.